Thank you for subscribing. Please follow me on Instagram at luima.raw. Watch the movie I was camera operator on down below, Hallowed Be Thy Name. It's out on a lot of streaming services. Please support indie cinema. And today we're going to talk about camera lenses. I want to divide lenses into two quick categories before we start. Zoom lenses, like this one, and prime lenses. Zoom lenses basically let you see from very wide to very close. They let you see the whole range of focal lengths. Focal length is that little number of the lenses that tell you how wide, normal, or tight the lens is. This is a prime lens. This is a manual prime lens. It is a 135. So it lets you see far away objects closer. The lower the number is, the wider it is. The higher the number is, the tighter or more zoomed in the lens is. We went outside to do a demonstration of this, going from 8mm all the way to 135, so you have a quick lesson about focal length starting now. For this demonstration, I'm gonna be about 11 feet away from my subject, and we're gonna see a variety of lenses going from wide all the way to very tight. This is the first lens that we're gonna showcase, is the 8mm lens. You can see it gives us a very weird distorted fisheye effect, as you can see the borders of the lens and our subject in the middle looks very, very far back. That's what wider lenses do. Wider lenses make our subject look far, far away. Now we're jumping into our next wide lens, which is the 20mm. A 20mm lens in this camera will let us see a lot of the scenery. We can see a lot around our subject. We can see her full body. We can see that she still looks pretty far away, but not as far as she was with the 8mm. So this is still a pretty wide shot. But now we're jumping into our first normal lens, which is the 35mm. This perspective that I'm getting with the 35mm is very close to what I'm seeing with my actual eyes from where I'm standing behind the camera. So a 35 is a good place to start when you're trying to find your framing. 35mm just looks normal on an APS-C camera. A 50 will give us a closer perspective than the 35, but not too tight still. So it's still considered a normal lens, a little bit more tight than normal. You know, it's a bit closer, the subject looks a bit closer than they actually are. But now we're gonna jump into our first tight lens, which is the 80. 80mm will show us that the subject is pretty close to us, not the closest we can get. But you can see her body fills up most of the frame, even though the camera is not moving from its spot. Now we're going to go with our tightest lens in this kit, is the 135 or 135mm. Her face fills up the whole frame and we're still 11 feet back. So with a 135mm, we can look at faraway objects and see them closer. This is a very quick recap. From 8 all the way to 135, you can see what focal length does to perspective, distance, and depth of field. Sensors. You have to be aware of the size of the sensor of your camera before you choose the lenses. Three main sensors you have to be aware about when we're talking about digital cinema: large format, APS-C or Super 35, and Micro Four Thirds. A camera with a bigger sensor will show more than a camera with a smaller sensor, which would show less. Simply put, the larger the sensor of your camera, the more angle of view you have from your lenses. And the smaller the sensor of your camera, the less angle of view. Which means a normal lens on this camera is a 35mm lens. I said it before in the demonstration of lenses. But if the sensor were Micro Four Thirds, which is slightly smaller, a 25mm would be considered normal. And if the sensor were bigger, a 50mm would be considered normal. So you start from there. You grab what your normal lens is, depending on the sensor of your camera, and you build your lens kit out of that. For example, here we have an APS-C or a Super 35 size sensor. So we start with a 35, and then we pick two wide lenses, let's say a 20 and a 16, and then two tighter lenses, a 50 and an 85. Finally, I wanna talk about aperture real fast, because aperture is another complicated topic that goes with sensor size and everything, but basically aperture is the opening of the lens. Blurry background or shallow depth of field is determined by three things: your focal length, your distance from the subject, and the aperture of your lens. The closer I am to the lens, might work here, the blurrier the background gets. But the further I am from the lens, everything starts looking more in focus, because the further I am, the more depth of field I'm gonna have, and the closer I am, the less. If I change this lens to a tighter lens, let's say for example a 50, I can flip this into 50 real quick. You notice that I'm still close to the camera and there is more blur in the background, because when I change the focal length to a tighter one, the background becomes blurrier. Aperture is how much light comes into your camera, but it determines how blurry your background is gonna be or not. Another quick thing before we go, why would you ever choose a prime lens over a zoom lens? This is just one lens and this is like five lenses in one. Well, a zoom lens does five lenses in one, but does them pretty okay. A prime lens does one lens, but does it really, really well, meaning that you can have a blurrier background, shallower depth of field, and sharper focus with a prime lens than you do with a zoom lens. You're trading versatility for better performance. This is a more versatile lens because I can just put this on a camera and I don't know what I'm gonna shoot, so I can either be wide or close. But if I know exactly what I'm shooting and what I'm gonna do, choose a prime lens. That way you know you're gonna have the best results you can get from the focal length that you're selecting. That is all for right now, because just knowing this little bit about lenses will let you choose the lenses you need in order to create your shot list, which is gonna be the next video next week. Next week, we're talking about shot listing, and we're gonna tie all that we've learned from lining a script to camera moves to now lenses. We're gonna tie in everything so shot listing makes sense and you can start shooting your own movies. Thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe, support the movie I was camera operator on. I'll be back next week talking about shot listing. So thank you for watching and supporting my channel. See you then.